like not to the point where I can risk any kind of strain, but it was at least a little kind of like stretch going kind of work maybe when you're not like that out. Then I did walk into the dog. Yeah, I would continue with the entire way. Typically, since track season's going to be October, or, you know, cross-country kids can be going, you know, if they're cross-country and track kid, they're going all year. Typically, you'll have 2 seasons away. So if I say I'm a basketball player, my season, my spring is where I'm going to generate the most power. Okay? So this is where my heavy lifting comes in, less on any kind of running. Summer, I'm going to start to add a little more plyometrics, a little more running, while maintaining some of my power, but I'm trying to build on it. Fall, as I'm getting closer to my running season, tailoring the portion down, increasing speed and agility, and in season, it's just completely so same idea, that's why the BAC works so well, because it's kind of simple. I can build for my newer athlete, but I can maintain for some of my say I've got a senior that's been with me 4 years, done this 4 years. They would just make me well and we're going to teach what they're doing.
Is that warm-up class?
Yep.
If this is what they want to go follow, then that's what warm-up.
Right, yep. Yep.
You can have them. If we're just getting into the stretching portion, you can have them do kind of like a little bit longer distance just after. That warm up lap's just to get a little blood flowing. So when they go into our dynamic warm up, we're able to get kind of those end of those range of motion stretches.
All right, well, I
want to
thank you all for coming out and please, so you have my information. If you have any questions at all, please feel free to contact me. I'd be more than happy to explain anything that I talked about today, send any information along, and best of luck this year.